Now in this video, we'll look at the construction of a reciprocating air compressor. So you can very well look at the diagram which is drawn on the board. Okay. So this is how the sectional view of a reciprocating single acting air compressor would look like. So you have your cylinders, okay, and you have your piston over here. This is the piston rod. Now the cylinder has water jackets. So these are the water jackets which has water in them, which takes away any excess heat that is generated inside the cylinder space. You also have cylinder, the water jacket space in the cylinder head. So this is the water jacket space in the cylinder head. Okay. Now you have this as your top dead center and this as your bottom dead center. Okay. Now from the distance between the volume between the top dead center and the bottom dead center is the displaced volume, okay, the displacement volume, and this much volume which is left unutilized is the clearance volume for, you know, because we need to have some space for the compressed fluid as well. Okay, now you have two valves. This is the suction valve and this is the delivery valve. Let me write it down. So this is the suction valve and this is the delivery valve. Okay, so on suction valve you have atmospheric pressure acting and on the delivery valve you have the receiver pressure acting. So this receiver pressure is keeping this delivery valve closed. Okay, now this atmospheric pressure cannot open this suction valve right now because the pressures are equalized. Okay, so what happens as your piston starts to move from top dead center to bottom dead center. Okay, initially there is some fluid in the clearance volume. Let us say air in the clearance volume. So when your piston initially starts to move from top dead to bottom dead center, whatever fluid is there, whatever air is left there from the previous cycle, it will start to expand. Okay, now on further movement of piston downwards, the pressure inside the cylinder would drop. Now the dropping of the pressure inside would open this suction valve. Okay, now as the suction valve opens, this atmospheric air would now be sucked in. Alright, now the pressure inside is lower as compared to the outside pressure. That is why the pressure from the atmospheric side is causing the air to flow in. Okay, but this pressure is more, so this will keep the delivery valve closed. So this is still closed as the piston moves down to bottom dead center. Okay, now it fills up the space. Now from bottom dead center the piston starts to rise up. Okay, now during the compression stroke actually what happens is, okay, let us say let's come to this PV plot first of all before I talk to you about that. So when the piston starts to move from top dead to bottom dead, I just explained that the suction starts to take place. That is shown by this line C1. Okay, now at 1 your piston reaches bottom dead center. Now from 1 to 2 you have compression taking place. So this compression is a polytropic compression. PV to the power n is equal to constant. Okay, now actually what happens is your delivery pressure is this, means your receiver pressure is P2. So you need to develop more pressure than P2 to discharge the air from the cylinder. Okay, so what happens is during the compression stroke the pressure developed is higher as compared to the delivery pressure is higher as compared to the receiver pressure. Why so? Because if the pressure is equal, then this delivery valve will not open, right? So to open this delivery valve, the pressure developed inside, actually this is a hypothetical PV plot, this is a theoretical one, this is not a practical one. We are also excluding the clearance volume. We are starting from zero volume. Okay, so during the compression stroke the pressure developed is higher than the receiver pressure. Due to that, this delivery valve will pop open. So it will open up like this, and the compressed air will move out into the receiver. Right, so this is how the reciprocating air compressor works, which is single acting in nature. Okay, so I hope you understood the entire working of it. So when it is at TDC, you have your clearance volume, and when it starts to move downwards, the receiver pressure again works on the delivery valve, it shuts it down. Okay, and the whatever air is left in the clearance volume, it starts to expand. On further going down, the pressure drops again, the suction valve opens, the atmospheric pressure comes in, and the whole cycle starts again. Now let's bring that onto this. So this is the PV plot. I told you that line C1 is the suction stroke. This is the suction stroke. That is, the inlet valve opens and the delivery valve shuts. Okay, then you have line 1 to 2 or curve 1 to 2. Okay, in this curve you have compression stroke. You have compression stroke. Now, during the compression stroke, both the valves have to be shut. So, both valves shut. Okay. So, as soon as it reaches pressure 2, it has to be more than P2. Okay. That is why the delivery valve will open, otherwise not. So, theoretically, when it reaches P2, the delivery valve opens and you have delivery taking place. So, this is 2D. So, 2D is delivery into the receiver. Alright, now from D to C, what happens is, this is return stroke from this pressure to this pressure without actually sucking in any volume of air. Okay, so this is what happens inside a single acting reciprocating air compressor. So I hope you understood this entire video representation, this sectional view of the reciprocating air compressor. Now after this video, let's move on to the next video and talk about the indicated work which is done by a single acting reciprocating air compressor. We'll explore more on this PV plot in the next video.